Something's always funny when I... Something's always funny to me when I start these things, and I don't know why.
But it is.
Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
We have already discussed that moving electric charges create magnetic fields. It really should be no surprise, then, that moving magnetic poles create electric fields.
Wait. So moving electric charges create magnetic fields, which cause magnetic forces on magnetic poles.
Which can move magnetic poles, and moving magnetic poles create electric fields, which cause electric forces on electric charges.
Which can move electric charges, and moving electric charges create magnetic fields.
Which is what I just said.
Yeah.
Exactly. Which is basically why an electromagnetic wave can self-propagate. But we're getting ahead of ourselves with that bit of logic. Let's just return to the fact that moving magnetic poles create electric fields. When a magnetic field changes over time, this can induce the same outcome as an electric potential difference, and it is called an induced EMF. An induced EMF can cause charge to flow in a closed loop of wire, which is called an induced current. More specifically, the relationship is between a changing magnetic flux and the resulting induced EMF in a single closed loop of wire, and is described by Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which states that the absolute value of the induced EMF equals the derivative of magnetic flux with respect to time, or the time rate of change of magnetic flux. In a bit, we will talk about the direction of the induced EMF and induced current caused by the changing magnetic flux. However, for now, let's only concern ourselves with the absolute value of the induced EMF.
What does EMF stand for?
Electromotive force.
Which is an electric potential difference.
But we just learned that a changing magnetic flux can induce an electromotive force.
Which is an electric potential difference.
And that induced EMF causes an electric force on an electric charge. Maybe that is why it is called an electromotive force.
That actually makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Correct, Bobby. That is why it is called an electromotive force. Nice work, everyone. Billy, I would like to discuss a point you made comparing EMF and electric potential difference. Both have units of volts, and both measure an energy source per unit charge. However, electric potential difference is a special case of EMF for conservative electric fields. And the difference in electric potential works out as a shortcut for determining work done on a test charge. When a changing magnetic flux induces an EMF, the field is not conservative. The work done on a test charge will depend on the path and will no longer be zero around a closed path. Faraday's law of induction induces non-conservative electric fields where EMF is no longer as simple as a difference of electric potential across two points. Okay, back to Faraday's law of induction, which I am going to expand on a bit. I'm going to add a capital N, which stands for the number of loops through which the magnetic flux is changing. We know magnetic flux equals the dot product of the magnetic field and the area vector of the loop through which the magnetic field is passing. And the dot product is the same as the magnetic field times the loop area times the cosine of the angle between those two vectors. Therefore, notice an EMF can be induced by changing the magnitude of the magnetic field, the area enclosed by the loop, the angle between the magnetic field and the loop area, which is theta in the equation, or my personal favorite, any combination of the three. For example, if the only one of these three variables, magnetic field, loop area, and the angle between the two, if the only one of those three variables which is changing is the magnitude of the magnetic field, then the induced EMF through one loop of wire equals the magnitude of the loop area times the cosine of the angle between the area vector and the magnetic field vector times the derivative of the magnetic field with respect to time.
That makes sense.
Sure.
Okay.
But what is electromagnetic induction? I don't think we've actually defined that yet.
Yeah, I can see that. Electromagnetic induction is the process of inducing an electromotive force by a change in magnetic flux.
Thanks.
You are welcome. And thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.